Good morning, students. So in the last video we were learning about pronouns, and out of 11 types of pronouns we talked about, or we studied four of them, which are personal, reflexive, empathetic or emphatic, and demonstrative pronouns. Now let us move with the fifth one, right? What is the fifth pronoun here? Fifth pronoun is indefinite pronoun. Fifth one is indefinite pronoun, used to talk about a person or thing indefinitely. We are not sure of what we are talking, but still we are making some statements. So when we make some statements of that kind, we need indefinite pronouns to talk about someone or something indefinitely. Like the words which we use for indefinite pronouns are one, something, anybody, any, no, and so on, etc. Example: one must know what one has to do. Here this one is not referring to the first one, but one must know. Somebody must know what he or she has to do. That's the meaning. Somebody. Some failed in exams. So some is a pronoun here. One is a pronoun. Some is also a pronoun. Some of them, some failed in the exam. We don't know who are they, but some failed in the exam. Something must be done about it. Something must be done about it. So these type of words are called as indefinite pronouns, which are used to talk about a person or a thing indefinitely. So next pronoun, interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns. Interrogation means what? To ask questions, right? So when we use some words to ask questions, we generally call them as interrogative pronouns. The words are who, whose, which, whom, what, all these WH words, or the WH questions, you remember them, right? So the words which are used to frame WH questions are called as interrogative pronouns. Why? Because these words do take the place of the noun there. For example, who is known as the father of nation? Well, the answer is Mahatma Gandhi is known as the father of nation. So the word who has been replaced in the place of Mahatma Gandhi. Mahatma Gandhi is a noun. So the word which takes the place of noun is called pronoun. So that is how who becomes a pronoun there. Which is the largest river in India? Which is the largest river? Brahmaputra is the largest river in India. So, word Brahmaputra has been replaced with the word which. So, interrogative pronouns means WH words are replacing the nouns there. Whose handwriting is this? You can tell anybody's name, right? So, that name of a person, place or a thing which replace those words are called as interrogative pronouns in WH questions. Next one, distributive pronoun, very important one. Distributive pronoun, used to talk about each and every person separately. Used to talk about each and every person separately. The words are each, either, none, both, everyone, neither, any, or one. These are some examples. There are many, but I cannot use all of them in this video. So I am just giving some examples here. So these words are used as distributive pronouns. Example, each of us has a book. Each refers to every individual. Got it? So that is how the sentence is being distributed there. Means it is made applicable to every person by using the word each. That is why we call this as a distributive pronoun. Everyone in the theater clapped with joy. So there are many people in the theater. There were many people in the theater then. So the sentence says everyone, each and every individual who was present in the theater clapped with joy. That is how distributive pronoun works. Neither of us passed the exam. So none, nobody among the group, distributive. Got it? So neither of us pass at the exam. So next one, reciprocal pronoun. Reciprocal to reverse, got it? Used to talk about mutual relations. The reciprocal pronoun is used to talk about mutual relationship, mutual between two people, each other, one another, got it? These are the words. The two sisters loved each other. Love is a verb, good. So whom they are loving? They are loving each other. In between the two sisters, the love is there. They cheated one another. Who cheated whom? They cheated one another. Among those two people, in between those two people, they cheated one another. So the reciprocal, it makes the reversal of the act there. Next one, relative pronoun. Relative, not any your relatives. The relative pronoun has a different meaning. It is used to combine or relate a sentence or clauses together. Or we can also call it as conjunction. What we can call it as? Conjunctions. Why? Because conjunction does the same work. It combines or relates a sentence or a clause there. So the words which do that job of combining a sentence or a clause there. So those type of words are called as relative pronouns. What are the words used as relative pronouns? Some of them are as, but, that, who, which, whom, etc. Example for relative pronoun sentence. The man who cheated you is not my brother. Well, even if he was, I would not have told that thing. The man who cheated you is not my brother. Who? Here there are two sentences. The man cheated you. He is not my brother. So when I am combining those two sentences with the help of who, then this who is referred to or called as relative pronoun. The book that you gave me was not interesting. The book that you gave me. You gave me a book is one sentence. That was the book was not interesting is the second sentence. I'm combining those two sentences with the help of that. So relative pronoun is that in this sentence. Got it? Please, if you find any doubts, don't forget to just ring me back or just message me and I will clarify your doubts on any of the pronouns there. Next one. Relative compound pronoun. Well, what is the difference between relative pronoun and relative compound pronoun? There is a word added here, compound. Compound means what? Relative pronoun which is compound added with the word ever, with the word ever. Whoever, whatever, whichever. So when these type of words are used, then they are referred to as relative compound pronoun. Example, whoever speaks the best wins the first prize. Whoever is a relative compound pronoun. I shall never forget you wherever I go. Wherever is a relative compound pronoun. Next one. Possessive pronoun. The last of pronouns. Possessive means what? To express ownership. To say that this belongs to me is called possessive. Right? So, possessive pronouns are used to express possession or ownership. These are used after the nouns. This is very important. Remember. Possessive pronouns are always used after the noun. Example, this book is mine. The word mine is a possessive pronoun. Book is mine. This garden is ours. Ours is a possessive pronoun. Because here mine and ours show the authority, the possession or the ownership of book and garden there. So when words do such things like expressing the possession on something, then we refer to them as possessive pronouns. Well, this ends your chapter on pronouns. If you have any doubts, then I have already told you people to just message me. I will be happy to reply to your doubts. And at the same time, I would also like to inform you that I am going to post some work for you people, like homework, which you people are supposed to complete and send them back to me for corrections, and even copy these things in your grammar notebook. Thank you.